be at Quad West soon, so I've given up on the idea of sleep. Outside the tunnels, the sun's probably coming up. I don't know why I'm writing this. I haven't written anything in ages. Not even in my diary. It's just so quiet on the hoop this time of the morning. It seems like the right thing to do. It's quiet because nobody has to get up from work. Except the beggars setting up their pitches at the man point. I guess they're the only ones with a full-time job. Rodice is asleep. She's scribbling on her collar. When she comes around, she'll swear she's been awake all night. My eyes feel like windows of the ringer. Dusty. Dirty. Never clean the ringer's windows. They ought to. It never rains in here. It never. Rodice and I went outside today, and I just can't stop thinking about it. The way the sun melted into the sea. I don't know what they do to blister windows to make the sun look like that, but I've never seen it from inside the ringer. Imagine seeing it every day. I just glimpsed a displacer. I'm sure it had a box on it. Perhaps I was telling me some. Did I hear Swifty Frisco mention Chop Letter signing somebody? Well, I hope so, for Ludy's sake. Maybe me and Rodice can go on tour with her. Yeah, maybe she'll let us carry her bags. I'd love to see you go.
You had an implant? You're 20.
Don't listen to me! What are you, like, 4 years old?